Hello everyone, welcome back to Jenda DIY. And today's video I'll be showing you how to crochet a phone bag. It is really easy pattern and really quick to make and also friendly for beginners. Okay, now let's get into the video. For crochet this bag, you can use any type and any size of yarn and any size of hook that fit with the yarn. To begin, we are going to make the bag base. Make a slip knot. And chain 17. If you guys want the bag bigger, please add more chains. After you got 17 chains, next we are going to make single crochet. For row 1, skip 1 chain and make single crochet into the second chain. To make single crochet, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 2 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all 2 loops. Keep repeating this into every chain until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, and this is what it looks like. Next, we are going to make increase by make 4 single crochet into the same loop. Please don't forget to use stitch marker to mark at this first single crochet stitch. It is easy to know where we start increase. After you got 4 stitches in the same loop, next we are going to make single crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, Next, we are going to make increase by make 4 single crochet into the same loop. Don't forget to use stitch marker to mark at this first single crochet stitch. After you got 4 stitches in the same loop, next we are going to make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. To make slip stitch, continue insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull through all the loops, and this is what the first round of the back base looks like. Next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work, and we are going to make increase by make 2 single crochet in the same loop for 4 times. It means that we are going to make increase into the next 4 stitches. After you got 4 groups of increasing stitch, remove stitch marker. Then continue make single crochet into every stitch until you have 4 last stitches from the stitch marker. Then I will meet you back again. After you got 4 last stitches, next we are going to make increase by make 2 single crochet in the same loop for 4 times. After you got 4 groups of increasing stitch, then continue make single crochet into every stitch until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. This is what the second row of the back base looks like. Next, for row 3 until row 4, chain 1, turn your work, and we are going to make single crochet into the stitch near chain 1. Keep making single crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row. Then we are going to make slip stitch to connect the row. Remember, for the small loop that near chain 1, it doesn't count as a stitch, so don't make single crochet into that loop. Next, for row 5, chain 1, turn your work, and we are going to make half double crochet into the stitch near chain 1. To make half double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 3 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. Keep repeating this into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch. Like I said, for the small loop that near chain 1, it doesn't count as a stitch. Just skip it and make slip stitch into the first half double crochet stitch. Next, for row 6, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row. Then make slip stitch. Next, 407, chain 1. Turn your work and we are going to make front post double crochet. As you can see, this is the slip stitch part and this is the first half double crochet stitch. We are going to make front post double crochet into that half double crochet stitch. To make front post double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook behind the half double crochet stitch. Grab the yarn and pull up. And now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2. And yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. And this is how we made front post double crochet stitch or alpine stitch. And for this chain 1 stitch, it is where we are going to make slip stitch at the end of the row. Next, turn your work and you can see behind the front post double crochet, we are going to skip 1 stitch that near chain 1. Then work a half double crochet stitch into the next loop of single crochet row. After you have made a half double crochet into the single crochet row, next we are going to skip 1 half double crochet and then we are going to make front post double crochet into the next half double crochet stitch by repeat the same thing like we did in the first stitch. After you have made a front post double crochet, then turn your work to see behind the stitch, skip 1 single crochet stitch and make a half double crochet into the next single crochet stitch. Keep repeating this around until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. Thank you. After you have made a front post double crochet into the last half double crochet stitch, then we are going to make slip stitch into the chain 1 stitch. Next, for row 8, please repeat row 6 by chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch. Next, for row 9, chain 1, turn your work, and this is what it looks like on the right side of the back or the right side of the alpine stitch. Next, we are going to make half double crochet on top of the front post double crochet that we did in the previous row. It means that we are going to make half double crochet into the single crochet row and also make half double crochet into the stitch that near chain 1. After you have made a half double crochet, next skip the front post double crochet and then work a front post double crochet into the normal half double crochet stitch. And for this first half double crochet that near chain 1, it is where we are going to make slip stitch at the end of the row. After you have made a front post double crochet, then we are going to make half double crochet into the next stitch of single crochet row. So you can see behind the stitch, skip 1 single crochet stitch and then make a half double crochet into the next single crochet stitch. Next, skip the front post double crochet stitch and then work a front post double crochet into the normal half double crochet stitch. Keep repeating this around until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you have made a front post double crochet, then skip one single crochet stitch and make a half double crochet into the next single crochet stitch. Remember, for this small loop that needs chain 1, we always skip it and then continue make slip stitch into the chain 1. And now we got 2 rows of alpine stitch, and this is what it looks like. For the next row, we are going to repeat row 6, row 7, and row 9 until you got 14 rows of alpine stitch. Then I will meet you back again. if you guys did want your bag longer, please add more rows by repeating row 6, row 7, and row 9 until you reach your desired length. After you got 14 rows of alpine stitch, and for the last row, you must end with a single crochet row as the border. Next, we are going to make the button holes. Continue from where your last stitch is, chain 1, turn your work. As you can see, this is the slip stitch part. For the slip stitch part, it should be placed at the back part of the bag. Next, we are going to make single crochet into the next 9 stitches. Then we meet you back again. After you got 9 stitches of single crochet, for at the last stitch, it must be placed at the middle part of the bag. As you can see, we want the button hole is placed at the middle part of the bag. So continue from where your last stitch is and chain 16. If you guys want it longer, please add more chains. After you got 16 chains, next, skip 9 chains. And make single crochet into the next 7 chains, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then continue make single crochet into the single crochet stitch around until you have 3 last stitches, then I will meet you back again. After you have 3 last stitches, then we are going to make the back strap. So for the back strap, it must be placed beside the bag, as you can see. Next, continue from where your last stitch is, and then make 180 chains. If you guys want the strap longer, please add more chains. After you reach 180 chains, next, we are going to connect the strap into the other side of the bag. Before you connecting the strap, make sure that the chain doesn't twist. Slip stitch into the corner of the bag. After you have made a slip stitch, then make another slip stitch into the next stitch. Next, turn your work and make single crochet into every chain until the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then continue make single crochet into the single crochet stitch until you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. Next, chain one and cut off the yarn. For the remaining yarn, please use the needle to weave in. And now you are done, and this is what the front part of the bag looks like. For the last part, we are going to make the button. To begin, make a magic circle or magic ring. Next, make 8 single crochet stitches into the circle. If you guys want your button bigger, please add more single crochet stitch into the circle. After you got 8 stitches of single crochet, then pull this short tail a little bit. And next, we are going to make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. Next, chain 1 and make 15 single crochet stitches into the circle. Next, make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. Then chain 1 and leave a long tail of yarn. It keep for sewing the button into the back. Next, pull the short string tight to close the circle and then cut it off. And for the long tail of yarn, use the needle to weave in around. And then pull it tight. And now your phone bag is done. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Stay safe and stay healthy, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.